Radians. Now, what is a radian? Well, first of all, we have to know what it entails. So, what are we looking for when we use a radian? Well, what we're looking for is the measure of an angle. And we already have that if we look at something as like degrees. Now, how do we identify a radian? What is a radian? Like, what's the like measurement of it? I'm going to answer everything right now. Now, first of all, what is a radian? So, as I explained, it's a way to measure an angle, but it's specific. So, if we look over here at this example that's already been drawn, you can see that from the vertex to the arc, there's this line. Now, this line is known as the radius. Now, what a radian does is it takes the length of a radius, and all it really does is just wrap it around the arc of the circle. And then you go and you take another radius and you connect it to the point of the other side, and that gives you your one radian. So, as I explained, radius, we've all understood that radius, right? Okay. So, what we do is we take this length, and then let's just say this is also another radius, right? So, all it really does is you're taking the length of a radius and you're wrapping it around the arc here. Like this. That right there, what I just marked out, that's basically a radius. It's not straight, but it was curved to match the arc of the circle so that it can match the angle. Now that we have that, we connect another radius to the point over here. And then there's two points and there's two radiuses meeting this third radius, which is curved. And this gives us our radian. This section right here that we've blocked off with the three separate radiuses, that gives us our radian. And note that all radiuses have the same length, so each side is the exact same in length. So what does this equal? Well, to give your exacts, one radian is about 57.2958 degrees. And that's for all radians. They're all basically in sections, but they equal the same. How many would you need for a whole circle? So one side is created out of 3.14 radians. Does that number sound familiar? Well, that comes from pi, or not. Yep, that is pi. 3.14 is pi, and that's how much the half or the 180 degrees or the semicircle of the circle equals. So if we want to find the whole circle, all we would have to do is multiply that by 2 to get our full circle. So let me just clean this up a bit. Okay. So yeah, that's basically all that is that. That's basically the basics to a radian, and I'll just show you an example so you can see it in full motion. So what you're going to see in this video right here is that they're going to show you the length of a radian outside, and then they're going to wrap it around the arc, just showing you, like giving you a vision of what it is. So see, they just wrap it around. It's the exact same, and each side, there's a radian, there's a radian, there's a radius, there's a radius, there's a radius, all the same. The only difference is it's a little bit the second one that you took out over here. It's just curved a bit so that it matches the arc. And that gives you your one radian. See? Radian, the angle made when we take the radius and wrap it around the circle. That's all there is to it. That's the degrees, 57.2958. How many does it make up? Well, half of it is 3.14. If you want the whole circle, you multiply it by 2.